Hello and welcome back to my channel. I bet you can guess what today's video is going to be, but it will be a wardrobe kind of tour. I am swapping around my wardrobe for kind of spring and summer, so I thought I'd film this whilst I was kind of doing that. So if you do like the sound of that, I know a few of you have been requesting it, then do subscribe and keep on watching. It will probably be a long video. I'm guessing it will probably be like an hour maybe, so definitely grab a drink if you're watching the whole thing, and I will get into the video now. So there's quite a lot of light on this side, which is why it's a bit dark, because my wardrobe door actually kind of blocks the light a little bit, but I will be going through all of my wardrobe, just kind of taking out the winter things, and also if I spot anything that I haven't worn in a really long time, then I might sell it on and just make a separate pile for that. But I will start with this side and kind of work my way down to this. Usually I have my dresses on this side, and then it kind of goes into my jumper dresses and jumpers, and then that goes into sweatshirts, then long sleeve tops here, and then skirts, and then also like my hoodies, and then I've got my big kind of furry coat there. Yeah, I will start with this side. So I do have a box that sits right at the very top of my wardrobe. I do have that on my floor right there, and that's got all my summer stuff in. So anything that's like super wintry, I will just put in the box and kind of swap everything out. I will kind of tell you the brands of everything. I won't be reviewing everything because I'd be here all day. If I've done hauls or reviews, I will link as many as I can in the eye for you, but there's a lot to go through, so I better get started. It's a nightmare just trying to get all that out. I have just taken out a few things because, as I said, I don't want this video to be like 2 hours or 3 hours. But at the very end, I have this shirt, and I think I had this in my last wardrobe tour, and I was also wearing this same t-shirt. I think I bought this off of eBay maybe, but it's kind of like a very Victorian inspired top with like the ruffles, and like the sleeves are kind of like this. I used to be really into like Victorian slash Lolita fashion, so I used to wear this like all the time with like a corset and everything. So I do have that. I don't wear this piece anymore, but I do still keep it because I got it quite cheap and I've never seen anything like it, so that's the first piece that I have. The next dress actually fell off of the hanger there, but it's the Tudor dress that I got from Boohoo, like with the kind of square neckline and the puffy sleeves, and it's like one of these. It says it's a midi dress, but it's a maxi dress on me. It's like super long. Again, haven't actually worn this, just haven't really had the opportunity to. I don't even know where I'd wear a dress like this, but I just needed a Tudor dress. Next up, I've got two KILLSTAR dresses. So I've got this one, which is the Lillian Lies KILLSTAR dress. I really like this one, but I haven't worn it in quite some time just because this back ruffle really irritates like my neck. I'm just like, ooh. But I do really like it as a dress. It's very doll-like. So that's what this one looks like. And one of my favorite dresses that just doesn't get enough love. I feel like this, the lighting's always going a bit strange. Sorry if the lighting keeps like changing. But this dress is the Death March dress, and I also did a haul on this too. And this one has the lace at the front. Very, very pretty dress. Kind of has this like underlayer to puff it out. This is honestly like one of my favorite dresses that I bought. But again, like, because of coronavirus, I haven't had any events to wear it to. Not just gonna walk to the post office in this like lacy Lolita dress. But I do have those two. I also have this dress, and this is the KILLSTAR Invoke Me dress. I absolutely love this one. It's got the collar and all the velvet. Hopefully you can see the print. And I did haul this one from Kate's Clothing. This is like perfect for a kind of summery, gothy vampire look. Like, I really like this piece. Next up, I've got some dungaree dresses. Now, I don't think these got as much wear as normal because I usually wear them to university quite a lot, but as I haven't been going there, then they haven't got as much use. But I do have this kind of cord one. that I just got from Select quite a few years ago. This is definitely the one that I wear the most, and it's just got a black basic Primark jumper on. I also have this one from Hell Bunny. This is like the checked kind of Alice inspired one. I actually got this one from Depop, but I do really like this. Again, it's just I don't know when I'd wear something like this. I do really like it when I put it on, but yeah, I'm not too sure. It would have been perfect when I did like the Alice escape room for my birthday like 2 years ago. But I do have this piece from Hell Bunny. And I've got two more kind of dungaree dresses. This one's fallen off the hanger. I've got this one, which is a denim one from H&M. I do wear this one quite a bit in kind of the spring, and it's just got a striped top from H&M. That's kind of what this one looks like. And then very similarly, I've got this one, which is a kind of like a fake suede with the zip that goes all the way down. Again, I've worn this one quite a lot. And this just has, again, another striped top. This one's actually more like a long sleeve t-shirt dress from H&M that I got for like £3. So do have these. These ones actually are ones that are quite new. So I wore this piece on like 2 days ago. And this is the Sadie baby doll dress. I absolutely love this dress. I hauled this one super recently, and at this point in filming it's in the sale for like £13, so highly recommend if you've been looking for this, definitely grab it. It's kind of velvet with this really pretty pattern on, laces at the front, again by KILLSTAR. I have this from, again, H&M, and I did haul this one. It's kind of got this really big oversized collar on it, kind of Lolita style I'd say, with kind of three-quarter length sleeves. I haven't actually worn this. There's been times where I've gone to wear it, but it's just a very kind of stiff material. I think I'll probably try some of this on and just see if I'm going to keep them or not, so that's probably what I'll do. And the next piece is from Disturbia. This is the, is it the bone smock dress or like the skull smock dress, I don't know, but it's the kind of skull print dress from Disturbia. I think I've got a just like a plain black long sleeve top from Primark under here. Really like this, and I've worn it quite a few times. The material probably isn't my favorite just because it goes quite staticky. Again, a new piece that I haven't actually worn is this one from Collective, I'm gonna say is how you say it, and it's the trick or treat dress. Again, just not had the opportunity to wear it. Hopefully I can get some wear out of it kind of summer, maybe going into Halloween. But there is this one, just kind of like a skater style velvet with this print on it, kind of dungaree style. So there's this. Next up, I've got a gorgeous dress that really doesn't get enough wear. I should have probably done a disclaimer before I did this. No one needs this amount of clothes. I'm just like obsessed with clothes and also a collector, so that's not a good combination. But I'm aware that no one needs this amount of clothes. So if you don't like this video, like, you don't have to watch it, but a few people have requested it. Probably should have said that at the beginning. But this is the, I don't remember the name of this one actually, but this is absolutely gorgeous. I probably should have got a smaller size just because it's a little bit big on me. But this is like a KILLSTAR long sleeve, very Victorian dress. I absolutely love the sleeves on this. And that's the front with all this lace. Just kind of like a very flowy kind of viscose dress. Very, very pretty. So this one again is from KILLSTAR. Two dresses on this hanger. This is the draconian dress. This has quickly become one of my favorites. It's perfect for layering. I wore it on Friday with the like Stacy black and white layering top from KILLSTAR. It's very, very pretty. And you can also wear it just on its own or with a mesh top. Very versatile. So that's what this one looks like, just kind of like a strappy dress with this more like blouse material. And then on the other side, I've got this new look kind of basic skater dress. And I also have this exactly the same dress, but also like a maxi dress, which is very, very pretty for in the summer to wear with like winkle pickers. So that's these two. I also have this dress, which I bought, when did I buy this? I think I bought it like end of 2020, and this piece is stunning, again from KILLSTAR. This went in the sale and I overlooked it at first, and I'm glad I got it like when I did before my size sold out. But it's a very like luxurious velvet with this cutout detail, a collar, frills, and the sleeves are what sold it to me. Like, look at that. I just love this dress. I wore this on Christmas Day actually, and it was very comfortable. I think this is the last dress now before I move on to jumpers and jumper dresses. So I do have this, and this was one I picked up on Boohoo. Was it Boohoo? No, Misguided. I got this one from Misguided. I wasn't really too sure what to expect, but my friend Natalie actually recommended Misguided to me, and I just kind of picked this up to see what it was like, and this has quickly become one that I've worn like so many times. It's such a comfortable dress. You can wear it on its own and it looks nice. It's like one of those smock dresses. It's got frills here on the sleeves, and then also a big frill on the bottom. So this is perfect for like modern Lolita maybe. But yeah, I was kind of surprised to find something like this in Misguided, but love it. Next up is a jumper dress. This one actually fell off the hanger, and this is a, again, KILLSTAR. There's a lot of KILLSTAR in here. This is a witch dress. This is quite an old piece now. This is so fluffy. Like, it's a bit like wide on me. Like, I should have got a size smaller, but I actually bought this off of eBay for like £8. So, you know, I wasn't too mad at the sizing, but this is just insanely fluffy. Like, hopefully you can see that. Like, this is that piece if you have to go out early and you just want to wear like a blanket out, like this is what you put on. And honestly, it's so much like a thermal piece, so it does just kind of go straight down. So yeah, really like this, and I always wear it over winter. I've got two more jumper dresses. This one is one I got from ASOS. It's by the company Brave Soul. This is like basic. It's just kind of a jumper, but it's maybe a little bit bodycon, but not too much. Like, it kind of just goes straight down like a tube, but it's also very flattering. There's not really any details on it. Like, that's kind of the knit up close. But this is perfect if you want to layer it with like a really statement belt and some jewelry and some boots. Like, it's a really nice kind of cozy piece you can jazz up with accessories. And similarly to that, I got this one from Primark years ago. Again, kind of similar idea, but it does tie in like a corset detail at the waist, and it's not as kind of bodycon-ish like the last one is. I do have these two. I do love a jumper dress. Moving on to jumpers now, I've got these ones, which are kind of longer style jumpers. So I've got this one. This is like original KILLSTAR. Like, this is one of the first pieces I ever bought from KILLSTAR, and it's the Pugsley knit. They've actually redone this now. It's more like distressed because they don't do this anymore. This I actually spilt, and I think I mentioned this in my last wardrobe tour, but I spilt something red there and it drives me crazy. So I do still have this piece. A lot of you actually bought these ones after I recommended them, and you love them too. And these are kind of the, what are they called? This one's called the Darklands knit jumper, and then this one, I don't remember what this one's called, but it's got like a purple version. So this is what this one looks like. It's kind of tartan, these little details. It's just basically a very long, cozy jumper. And then there's this one, which is the grey version. The grey versions are a little bit thinner, but I do really like both of them. So I've got these. I lived in those through like the majority of the lockdown. I've got some more kind of stripy jumpers. So this one I've had, again, from Primark for years and years. I'm not sure where it cut me out, but I got this one from Primark years and years ago. It's kind of had its time, I'd say. It's gone very kind of, you know, bobbly and a bit, you know, not the best. But this is perfect if I want to wear something with a skirt. It looks very flattering tucked into a skirt. It doesn't look weird or anything. So I do have this that I got from Primark ages ago. When I usually buy things from high street or like cheaper shops like Primark, they always last me a really long time. I don't know if it's just I find the better quality pieces, I don't know, but it's been very rare that I've worn something from Primark a few times and that's been it. And I got this one from Top Man, and this is a kind of lavendery purple and black striped top. I absolutely love this piece, and I got this really cheaply because it was in the sale. And I also have, you can tell I like my stripes, this one from H&M. Again, I got this one really recently with that collared dress, and this is just a black and red striped jumper, and I got this for £10 because it was priced wrong. So I do have all of these colors. I really prefer these to like the KILLSTAR ones because I don't like all the holes they have in them. I prefer just to be cozy. So I do have all of these. This is very similar to that jumper dress. It's basically a jumper, just black standard from Primark. This one's very soft feeling, and it looks good with kind of my tartan skirt. So do have this. Next up, I have some cropped jumpers. So I have this one from Topshop. Again, this is very similar to that kind of fluffy jumper dress from KILLSTAR. I'd say this is softer, like the material is just, it's so nice, you just want to hug it. So I do have this. Again, the neckline's a little bit bigger than I'd like, but this is perfect for tucking into skirts. Again, like I usually wear this with, I don't know if you can see it, like these two, more like winter skirts, or this lilac-y skirt. I got this in the sale too. My throat's really gonna die across this video, so sorry if it's a bit like ugh. But I do have this one from Primark. This I've probably had for about 8 years, so it's definitely lasted. I'd say it's kind of on its last legs. It's gone very bobbly. It's not as soft as it used to be, but it's still going strong. There's no holes in it or anything, and it has the most adorable little ghost, and he's still kind of fluffy. But this was definitely like what I wore in my baby bat days, like this with leggings with my red Doc Martens. It was just like my whole outfit. So yeah, I still have this, I still wear it. This was when Primark had like Atmosphere labels, so it's definitely an old piece. Two more kind of cropped jumpers. I have this, and I'm in a dilemma about this. This is actually so soft. So this is basically like the Topshop one, but the neckline is insane. Like, it's more like an off the shoulder, but it's really thick, and it's the same material as the Witch jumper, but because it's not been washed as many times, it's literally like the most fluffiest thing. Like, it's so soft. And this says Bite Me across it. And I absolutely love this jumper, but I don't know what to pair it with. Every time I've put it with a skirt, it doesn't look right. Every time I've put it with a dungaree dress, it just, because it's so baggy, because it is a size medium, I should have got this in an extra small, to be honest. Like, it's really big, but they don't do this one anymore. It's quite an old piece. And again, I got it in the sale for about like £10-15. So I mean, it's so fluffy and I love it, but I just don't know what to wear it with. So if you have any suggestions of what I could put this with, do let me know, because I really like it, but it doesn't ever get worn, to be honest. I've worn it a few times and it didn't look right, and then I just haven't really worn it since. So do let me know if you have any suggestions. And then in the same style as that, I do have this one. But this neckline isn't actually as big, despite it being the same size. Like, this can actually sit on a hanger, whereas the other one just falls off constantly. This one isn't as fluffy because it has been washed, but I have worn this with dungaree dresses, and it's just basically a black and white striped jumper. I don't know why, but this is more easy to style. I don't know if it's because it's a bit longer, I don't know. But there's definitely a difference between this and the other one, but I do have that. Last two jumpers now. So I do have this that I bought from H&M around Halloween in the sale. It's a very soft, kind of thinner jumper, and it's got all these eyes, which is just so cool. So if you brush them down, they turn black, and then if you brush them up, they've got all these red eyes. I think this jumper's really cool, maybe a little bit childish, but I like the sequins. The only thing is, like, this is the scratchiest thing, so that's what puts me off wearing it. But again, a lot of my stuff I get in the sale, so I think I got this for like £5, so I do really like it. It's really cool, it's a cool concept, but it's just a little bit scratchy. One kind of jumpery cardigan left. This is from Jawbreaker, like old Jawbreaker. I'm not too into the stuff they do now, to be honest. It's a bit random in my opinion. You know, like they have like Sabrina inspired with the lace, but then they've got rainbow stuff, and then it's like 80s, and then it's just very mixed, and it does, I don't know. I like old-fashioned Jawbreaker. I do have some of their dresses. I had one of their skirts. I really liked their printed range. I have the bug dress. I liked their nautical style they did. I liked the skulls. I do have this, and it's just basically a black and white cardigan with skulls. I do wear this as a jumper though, like just this with a skater skirt. I do have some sweatshirts next. So this is the McGoth one. Obviously from KILLSTAR. Really, really like this one. I wore this a lot when I did my foundation degree. It was just very comfy to wear. I also have this one, which is actually a size extra small. This one's a small, but this one isn't as comfortable, and I don't really wear this one, so I am going to be selling this on my Depop shop. I've already tried selling it on Instagram, but no one bought it, but I will be putting this on my Depop shop. Some more sweatshirts. I think I've got another one of these, but it's somewhere else. But I've got this one. These are all from H&M around Halloween. So there's this one. It's got moons on. Kind of more simplistic. I do actually have this in two sizes. I know that's a bit strange, but I have it in an extra small, so I can wear it with a skirt. And then I also have a medium, which is really nice with leggings. So I do wear both, and that's really weird, but I think I picked up one of them for like £3. So yeah, I do have this one. And I also have this one that says "With My Witches," which was obviously around Halloween, just kind of gray. These are very comfortable. They're more like a thinner sweatshirt, not like the KILLSTAR ones. And I also have one, it's like a baby pink, and it's got black bats on it. The only pink thing I actually have, but I think that one's in the box maybe. The last sweatshirt hanging up is this one, and this one I've definitely got a lot of use out of. This is the Creep It Real Primark sweatshirt. Now, my Primark didn't have this at all, so a lovely lady called Susan picked this up for me, who also picked up the Halloween cushion, and I obviously PayPal'd her the money and everything, but I was so grateful for her for picking this up for me. It's a really nice, like, fleecy sweatshirt, really, really nice quality, and I got this in a small, but this item was so oversized. Like, this is a small. Like, it's huge, but I really like that it's oversized, because I just wear it with leggings. So this is actually from Primark. So next up is long-sleeved tops. Now, I've got this one, which is really recent. Like, I've just hung this one up. This was from the Crafty Burrito subscription. So I've got this that says "Disney Till I Die." This I'll definitely wear more as, like, a lounging top, I think. Just because it's a little bit more plain. I was thinking of like a nightshirt, but the material is a little bit thin for that. So this is definitely going to be a loungewear top, but that's where that one's from. And also this. This has definitely become one of my favourites, even though it's not what I expected when I got it. But this is the Disturbia Transylvaniac top with the castle on, with all the print down the sleeves. I've worn this in quite a few videos actually. But I really love this piece. So I've got those two. I've got these. And this top actually got worn on New Year's Eve into New Year's Day. And this is the KILLSTAR Antonia top. I love this piece. This is one of my favourites that they've brought out actually. I love the sleeves. I love the cameo. It's so gorgeous. So I do have this. And very similarly to that, I got this from Shein before I found out and watched Emily's video. But I did get this, which is very similar, and it's actually a really nice quality. But it's got this frill around the neck. Frills here. So it's very kind of like modern Victorian, I'd say. Like, the sleeves are kind of normal compared to like the other top, but this I'd say is more practical if you want to wear something still nice but you don't want sleeves like this that are going to get in everything. So I've got these two, and then I've got these. Now these are all very similar, so I'll just kind of whiz through these. Are these all from, yeah, these are all from Primark. So these are the kind of knitted tops. Very, very comfortable. They look small, but they stretch. And usually in normal times, I get a lot of use out of these because, as I said, I wear them with like dungaree dresses to university. I just wear them a lot because they're very comfortable and warm. So I've got one in black. I've got one in like an emerald green color. And I also have one in red. So I do have these. And in a very similar style, I've got this, and it's like, again, this is a very old piece. I don't remember when I got this. It could be maybe like four or five years. You can kind of tell it's faded a little bit, like close up in the light. But it's very pretty, and again, I think I got it for like £3. So, love this piece. This looks really nice with like a metallic skirt that I have that I'll show you when I get onto these skirts there. And I also have this one, again from Primark, and this is a green checked top. This I actually love wearing with like a black skater skirt, a belt. Then I can layer loads of necklaces, like crystals and stuff. So, got this one. These are the last long sleeve tops before I go on to the KILLSTAR striped ones. So I've got this one, which I got from Brandy Melville in America. It's kind of cropped-ish, and then it's got these striped sleeves. And then I also have this one, which is checked. I haven't actually worn this one yet. I got this one from Stradivarius. I got this one to put with trousers that just didn't end up fitting me. So, but I do have this. This would be a nice spring piece. And then I've got these long sleeve tops. Now, I've also got a purple version, which is in a bag, like right underneath my tripod, that I need to put up when I re-put my clothes back. But I've got this one, which is a slightly different style. This is the orange one. I think these are called the Azora tops. So I got this in orange. This is literally one of my favourite... Oh, I say that. I was going to say one of my favourite things they bought out, but I literally love so much from KILLSTAR. I know a lot of people like diss them and everything, but I really do like them as a brand. Just don't buy their footwear. I got this one, and I also have the same, but in grey. Again, with the zip. These are super flattering. Really like these. And then I've got these ones, which are the stretchy layering tops. So I've got this one in red. Very nice, like deep cherry red. And these tops also have the thumb holes too. Where is it? There. Hopefully you can see that. And I have the same one in black and white too. Again, I really do like my stripes. So I do have this. I also have a purple one, which will be in my KILLSTAR haul, the one recently that I put up. And I'm hoping they bring out a deep green because that would be really pretty. Okay, these are the last few tops. I've got this one, again from KILLSTAR. This was a vampire top. Love this. Absolutely love this one. I also have a one with like Dracula on, but I think that's in my box down there with my summer clothes. This I bought oversized so I could layer tops underneath it. I also have this one, which is actually one I made with my cozy winter ghost. He will have to go away so I can bring him out for Christmas. But that's my little winter ghost. I also have an autumn one that's in the box. And I also have this from October 31st, which has got ghosts on. Kind of in tombstones. So I've got these three. And just when I remember, I also have my spring ghost. If you are interested in one of these, I've got a pre-order up right now, so you can get yourself a spring cozy ghost t-shirt if you would like. That last hanger is for this top. So I do have this, and this is from Restyle. Very, very cozy, long, kind of baggy top that I always go back to if I'm just having like a cozy, comfy day. Next, I've got skirts. So I've got this one. This is from Select. Just a very basic velvet skirt. I wore this to death, so the velvet's kind of had its time. it's not really soft anymore, but this is a really nice skirt, still going. I also have these two, and these were released around the same time. So I've got this one, which is the KILLSTAR. I don't remember the name of this one. Is it Nadine? One of them's a Caspia lace skirt, and one of, is it the Nadine velvet skirt? But this is definitely more like luxurious velvet because it hasn't been washed as much. And then it's got the lace at the bottom. So I got that one. And then I recently bought this off of my friend in a bigger size, and this fits so much better. And this is the Caspia lace skirt. Very, very pretty. So next up, I've got some, well, I've got this one from KILLSTAR. Again, a very old style. This is their pentagram skater skirt in velvet. And on the other side, I've got, again, that same select one, but in purple, like a plum purple. And then on the next hanger, I've got this skirt, and this is from Select, but I got it off of Depop. A red tartan skirt with all these pleats. And on the other side, I've got this one. This is from Dark in Love, and it's that really nice wintry tartan with these stars. So got these. I also have this. Now this has three skirts on. So on this side there's this punk rave skirt. Got this one for Christmas recently. Absolutely love that. And then on the other side I've got this purple tartan. Again pleated. And this was from H&M. This is, I love this skirt so much. It's perfect for like the winter with jumpers and then the spring with different tops. And then underneath this I've got this red tartan, more like an A-line skirt, and I got this from Forever 21 in America. So yes, you can tell I like striped tops and tartan skirts. So these two are some of my favorite skirts. So I've got this, which is the Doom Doll skirt from KILLSTAR. Very, very like, I don't know, lolita-y almost, because it's very puffy, but then it's got these eyelets on. I love this skirt. And then I've also got this, which is the Mitzi mini skirt from KILLSTAR with all the crosses in velvet. I still need to wear this. I need something to wear this to because this is gorgeous and I just need to wear it. This is from H&M, but I got it off of Depop, just like a basic skater skirt. And on the other side, I've got this one. Is this from Dark in Love? Yeah, this one's from Dark in Love. This is more like a grungy skirt. It's got the big zip down here, with a belt and a pocket. Onto A-line skirts now. This was the metallic one I talked about earlier. I got this one from Topshop. Look at that, that is metallic. And then I got this, oh, my lighting's gone. This from Primark, just like a gray, well, it's just gray stripes, really. And then I got these two leather ones. This one I got from Primark for, again, about £3, just a basic kind of leather skirt with zips. And then this one I bought off of Depop, but again from Primark. I wore these like a lot a few years ago when I was really into like the trad goth look with like this and winkle pickers. I still like that, but I just don't wear them as much. Last few skirts now. So I've got this from Restyle. I really wanted this skirt for so long, and then I bought it off of Depop, but it's very like crinkly. And this is it ironed, so it's not, I think it's nicer in the photos to be honest, but I do wear this in the summer. And I've got my ghost skirt here, of course. That was from KILLSTAR, by the way, the ghost one. This is my denim jacket. I do have this that I got from Zara is where I got this one from. I've got some pins on it. This is that one that I bought from eBay for like £2. It's also in gingerbread coffin. And I also have these ones here from Mysticum Luna. And that one's from Dolly Cool. And then I also have a Beetlejuice top under here. It says, I myself am strange and unusual. So I've got this denim jacket. I've got two hoodies. So I've got just a basic zip up from Primark. Very basic. And then this one, which I love, is from KILLSTAR. This is the Bad Moon Rising hoodie. like, I won't be able to link every haul that I've done, so if you are interested, if you just go to my playlist and click on hauls or Killstar hauls, you should be able to find it in there. But I do have these hoodies, and I also have this. Now, this is literally like everything. So I've got like a skull scarf from Spooky Box on here, but this is my fur coat and I love it. It's not real fur, obviously, but this was from H&M and I got it for like £20, and it is the warmest coat, and it's just fluff. Like, look at this. Look how, like, it's just like a hug when you wear it. It's the coziest thing. I'm so, it cut me off when I was talking about my coat. Yeah, this is like the warmest thing. I love wearing it. Like this with like some stompy boots. I was saying that I was sad that we're going into summer now because this won't get any use, but I absolutely love it. I wore it so much over winter, so it's definitely worth the price. I really wanted a fur coat for years, but whenever I tried them on, because I'm quite short, they just made me look chubby and just not what I wanted. But this is like the perfect length. Like, it's from like here with the shoulders to there, so it's not like the longest thing, but it's long enough. So that's my wardrobe cleared out. All of this stuff at the bottom, like, that's a hat, I've got a dressing gown, blankets, all my bags are down here, so this is all gonna need sorted before I put my stuff back in. I also have, very randomly, plague doctor mask. I actually made this. Like, look at the glue. Oh my gosh. But this is actually a plague doctor mask I made. Just got all sorts back there. But yeah, so that's, as you can see, all of my wardrobe. I'm gonna put the stuff that I want to keep in here, like kind of long sleeve tops, short sleeve tops, anything like that, back in here. I will keep my jacket in there just because I got nowhere else for it, but I want to start having my spring and summer things in here now. I have to put away kind of the velvet long sleeve dress. But yeah, so that's what I'm gonna do now. So I thought I'd just quickly show you what the finished thing looked like. So this is the finished kind of spring summer wardrobe. So some of the things stayed the same, like some of the dresses back there, but I've also got some new pieces, like loads and loads of dresses, like from my wardrobe, like from there all the way to there is dresses, which is a lot more than I had in the winter. Got smaller area of sweatshirts for if it gets a bit cold, and then long sleeve tops. Then all my short sleeved tops are now here. I don't really have too many long sleeved ones left. And then I've got all of my skirts, and yeah. So that is how everything looked in the end. And I also tidied up this area earlier, so it's a bit better. But yeah, so that's my finished spring wardrobe. That's my wardrobe tour. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and it wasn't too long. As I said, this isn't a brag, it's just that some people requested this video, and I'm happy to do it. So yeah, I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, you can give it a like, and remember to press the notification bell. As I said, comment down below if you've got any styling options for that Bite Me jumper thing, because I don't know what to put with it. And also let me know if you've got any of the things that I showed you, and hopefully I will see you in my next one. Bye!